happy to see everyone.
Let's head to Las Vegas, where former Philippine Vice President Leni Robredo sought more support in the U.S. for her non-government organization, Angat Buhay.
It is such an honor to be at the receiving end of all your help. And what makes it sweeter is the fact that even if you are so far away from home, pinaglalaban niyo pa din yung ating bansa.
The Southern Nevada community gathered to show support for Angat Buhay, which focuses on education by building classrooms in remote areas of the Philippines. Robredo says Angat Buhay remains committed to implementing community-driven development programs centered also on healthcare, disaster response, and community empowerment.
We can't just be doing relief work. We can't just be doing rehabilitation work. It has to be preventive also.
And finally, Philippine band rock stars Paul Sapiera sang his greatest hits in the 90s as he headlined the recent Asian Street Food and Music Festival at Harvard Square in Cambridge, Massachusetts. Interestingly, Sapiera's own children performed on the very same stage in the last 2 years. In 2022, rapper Easy Mill headlined the show, with rain following a year later, also at Harvard Square. Easy Mill has since signed with Eminem's Shady Records, Dr. Dre's Aftermath Entertainment, and Interscope Records.
Eminem is my age. We're the same age, 52, 53, like that. And Eminem treats my son like a younger brother. He mentors my son. And my son pays attention to his advice. And also Dr. Dre is an older guy. They treat Easy like a little brother.
And those are the news-making headlines today. You can catch more TFC News on the ABS-CBN News website, YouTube channel, and app. I'm Henny Espinosa. Back to you guys at the Rundown.
U.S. Attorney General Merrick Garland denouncing former President Donald Trump's claim the FBI was authorized to shoot him during a 2022 search of his Florida property. Garland says Trump and his allies are referring to a standard operations plan that limits when agents can use lethal force while executing search warrants. The FBI searched the Mar-a-Lago resort in August 2022 to retrieve classified materials Trump retained after leaving office. Trump was not present when the search took place.
On that one, that allegation is false, and it is extremely dangerous. The document that is being referred to in the allegation is the Justice Department's standard policy limiting the use of force. As the FBI advises, it is part of the standard operations plan for searches, and in fact, it was even used in the consensual search of President Biden's home.
In fundraising messages sent by his campaign this week, Trump claimed the FBI was authorized to attempt an assassination. Clashes break out between police and protesters at the University of California, Los Angeles. This came just hours after the head of the university told a U.S. House panel the school should have been ready to immediately remove an encampment of pro-Palestinian activists that became the site of a violent clash with counter-protesters last month. The university removed the heads of its campus police Wednesday over the handling of the protests. Students have set up encampments and held rallies on dozens of campuses across the U.S. to call on President Joe Biden to do more to end the war in Gaza and to demand their schools divest from companies that back the Israeli government. U.S. President Joe Biden reiterating Washington does not recognize the jurisdiction of the International Criminal Court. Earlier this week, ICC prosecutor Karim Khan requested arrest warrants for Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu, his defense chief, and three Hamas leaders for alleged war crimes and crimes against humanity. The U.S. is not a member of the ICC, but has supported past prosecutions, including its decision last year to issue an arrest warrant for Russian President Vladimir Putin over the war in Ukraine.
We've made our position clear. on the ICC. We don't think we don't recognize the jurisdiction of the ICC, the way it's being exercised, and it's that simple. We don't think there's an equivalence between what Israel did and what Hamas did.
Meanwhile, the International Court of Justice is set to issue a ruling Friday on South Africa's request to order a halt to Israel's Rafah offensive. The demand is part of a larger case brought before the Hague-based court by South Africa accusing Israel of genocide. The top UN legal body has no way to enforce its decisions, but a ruling against Israel could add to its political isolation. Taiwan President Tsai Ing-te vowing to defend the values of freedom and democracy in the face of external challenges and threats. Lai made the comments while visiting an army camp. On the same day, China launched what it called punishment drills around the island. Taiwan has deployed its forces in response, saying it was confident it could defend its territory. The two-day exercises came just 3 days after Lai took office, a man Beijing views as a separatist. China, which sees Taiwan as its own territory, denounced Lai's inauguration speech on Monday, in which he called on Beijing to stop its threats and said the two sides were not subordinate to each other. Two Filipino passengers injured on a Singapore Airlines flight hit by turbulence are reportedly in sensitive condition in a Thailand hospital. The Philippine Migrant Workers Department says one of them has a neck fracture and back injuries. The other passenger is still unconscious and confined in an intensive care unit. The DMW says Singapore Airlines has committed to paying their hospital expenses. Three other Filipinos injured during the flight remain in stable condition. The son of former Philippine President Rodrigo Duterte seeks a congressional probe on extrajudicial killings in the country. But some lawmakers question the scope of the inquiry proposed by Davao Congressman Paulo Duterte.
Davao City Representative Paulo Duterte urges the lower house to conduct a broader investigation into what he called the real situation in extrajudicial killings and human rights abuses in the country. He filed a resolution this week seeking a probe into EJKs not only in Davao, but across the country over the last 25 years. Congressman Duterte cited reports that state EJKs remain a serious problem up to this day and even peaked in 2023, a year after his father, former President Rodrigo Duterte, stepped down. But Party List Representative Nicanor Briones, a member of the House Committee on Public Order and Safety, told Teleradio Servicio the scope of the investigation being pushed by Congressman Duterte may be too broad.
Tayo, sang-ayon dyan sa panukalang yan, ang hindi ko lang maintindihan bakit sobrang tagal ko, 25 years ang pag-umpisa.
Opa.
Pero kung tutusin, dapat lahat ng mga extrajudicial killing ay talagang naimbestigan sapagkat gusto natin na matigil na yung pagkakitil o pagpatay ng ating mga kababayan. Sobrang haba niyan. Tapos na 19 Congress, di pa tayo tapos. So pinakamaganda, umpisa natin doon sa panahon ni President Duterte hanggang sa kasalukuyan.
The Makabayan Bloc of Lawmakers seized the call of Duterte as a way to divert attention to the human rights violations committed under his father's administration. Gabriela Representative Arlene Brosas finds it ironic that the resolution would come from A. Duterte.
Hindi katiwa-tiwala yung source eh, kasi yung merong problema dun sa respect and protecting and fulfilling human rights, no? Na hindi nag-adhere na previous administration ang gagaling yung ganong pahayag. So, ganong resolution mula sa mga Duterte na merong ganitong record, track record on human rights violations. Kaya din naman parang pakakaisipin mo, parang ganon, this is ironic.
The Makabayan lawmakers reiterated their call to hold former President Duterte accountable for his administration's drug war, and they hope the International Criminal Court will issue a warrant of arrest against personalities involved. Meanwhile, Police Colonel Richard Badang, the chief of the Davao City Police, has been relieved from his post after a probe on 7 deaths at the hands of the police during anti-drug operations from March 23 to 26 this year. A spokesperson for the Police Regional Office 11 said this was done to ensure that the investigation is independent and credible. The drug-related killings took place after Davao City Mayor Sebastian Baste Duterte declared war on illegal drugs.
The Senate's position on charter change seems to be the same despite Monday's major leadership shakeup. Senate President Francis Escudero says his colleagues remain wary of the move amid fears the Senate's vote could be diluted. He vows to block any move that may weaken the upper chamber.
So manalo matalo, dumating ang punto na ini-insist ng lideratong pagbotohan kahit talo. Tinutulan namin yun. Eh, alam mo po lang talo, ba't pagbobotohan pa? Di ba?
Mm-hmm.
Yun na nga lang yung pumipigil. Tatanggol ko at hindi ko papayagang lumabnaw. Ano mang kapangyarihan, ano mang prerogative, meron ng Senado sa ngayon.
Escudero also expressed willingness to mend tense relations with the lower house. The House and the Senate, under the leadership of then-Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri, had engaged in a word war over differences on charter change and the People's Initiative. House Speaker Martin Romualdez welcomes Escudero's move.
Sana maayos, wala nang palitan ng maanghang na salita. Dahil kahit naman hindi kami nagkakasundo sa isa o tatlo o maraming bagay, hindi rason yun para maghugas kami ng maduming damit, ika nga sa publiko, at magsabihan ng kung anong salita na hindi parliamentary.
Yan ang pinagmadala sa demokrasya. Lahat yan pwede pag-usapan, ipupulong-pulong natin, makukokus tayo. Kami po sa House, we look forward to challenges. At we always enjoy working with our friends in the Senate.
The Catholic Bishops' Conference of the Philippines calls the absolute divorce bill anti-family. It says the passage of the measure at the lower house is a betrayal of the constitutional mandate of lawmakers to uphold marriage and family. It adds there are already existing legal remedies to address problematic reunions. On Wednesday, the House of Representatives passed the divorce bill with 131 yes votes, 109 no, and 20 abstentions. As for the upper chamber, Senate President Francis Escudero says he is unsure if the measure will have the numbers. He adds he's more in favor of annulment rather than allowing divorce.
Mas nais kong palawakin at gawing affordable at accessible yung annulment na nasa family code natin ngayon. Sa paanong paraan, payagan ng PAW, tanggapin ang mga kaso tulad nito. Nagsabi na ang Supreme Court na hindi na kailangan ng psychologist para mapatunayan ang psychological incapacity. At pangatlo, para mas maliwanag, i-define ng Kongreso ano-ano nga ba ang psychological incapacity.
Senate President Francis Escudero warns against a selective ban on gambling. He says a total ban may be more favorable if the goal is to address crimes linked to gambling. The Senate is pushing for an absolute ban on pogos.
Okay. Maglilisa talaga tayo. Mahirap yung may tinitingnan at may tinitigan. Mahirap yung tila may pinag-iinitan lang at may pinapabayaan naman. Kung magkakaroon tayo ng pulisya laban sa iba't ibang masasamang gawain na konektado sa sugal, edi i-review na natin lahat.
Calls to ban pogos were renewed amid controversies involving Banban Tarlac Mayor Alice Goh. The Senate is investigating her alleged ties to illegal pogos in the province and the possible links of pogos to criminal activities like human trafficking, money laundering, and online scams. Goh's citizenship and assets are also under scrutiny. Families displaced in the militant siege of Marawi City in the southern Philippines continue to call for just compensation 7 years on. Rafael Busano reports.
It has been 7 years since the Marawi siege, but displaced residents are still facing considerable challenges. One of the major issues is the matter of compensation. Marawi residents are appealing to the Marawi Compensation Board to junk a resolution which they say aims to diminish the value of their claims. Locals are rejecting the conservative computation of the compensation board. At least one civic leader said his mother, who lost her home in the fighting, should get more than 3 million pesos as compensation, but will only receive less than half of that amount.
Pag titingnan natin yung batas, interpret natin ang batas, tingnan natin ito sa paningin na ito ay isang human right issue, na ito ay isang reparation. Babayaran ng gobyerno yung mga nawala sa atin, at hindi lang yung nawala sa atin, kundi pati yung healing ito, healing para makabalik tayo at maitayo natin muli kung ano yung nawala sa atin noong 2017.
But the Marawi Compensation Board has argued they are allowed to determine the fair market value of damaged properties.
Sa IRR, mistake natin, punto po punto, ang replacement cost doon. Yung fair market value, makikita naman na ito doon sa inadapt namin na 2021 schedule of fair market value ng province, automatic po, pag nag-compute po tayo ng fair market value, built-in, nandoon na ho ang depreciation.
For Marawi Mayor Mahul Usman Gandamra, it wasn't just the destruction of homes and properties. The conflict was an assault on their collective spirit and way of life.
Po yung mga pila sa ating government through the MCB na sana ay may bigyan natin sa ating mga kababayan yung karampatang kompensasyon. Hindi lang ang binabayaran dito yung structures, kundi pati yung mga corresponding sufferings, yung trauma na experience na ating mga kababayan.
Based on data gathered by the ABS-CBN Investigative and Research Group, the Marawi Compensation Board has already distributed over 148 million pesos of claims, covering from death, structural, personal, and property damage. The filing period for compensation claims will end on July 3, and after this, the board will no longer accept applications. Rafael Bosano, ABS-CBN News.
Let's now get an update on the weather from Pag-asa forecaster Aldzar Aurelio. Hi, Aldzar.
Hello, good morning to all of you. The low pressure area east of Surigao del Sur has developed into a tropical depression and was named Aghon. As of this moment, the center of Aghon was at 340 kilometers east of Hinatuan, Surigao del Sur. Aghon has a maximum sustained winds of 45 kilometers per hour, while gustiness of up to 55 kilometers per hour. Because of this scenario event, we raised a tropical cyclone wind signal number 1 over eastern Samar, Dinagat Island, Siargao Island, and Bocas Grande Islands. These areas will have scattered rain showers, frequently heavy rains, and also expect gusty winds. Today, because of Aghon, we expect heavy rains over Surigao del Norte, Dinagat Islands, northern portion of Surigao del Sur, eastern portion of southern Leyte, and southern portion of eastern Samar. Because of this event, we advise that take precautionary measure due to the heavy rains, possible landslide and flash flood, especially of low-lying areas and near rivers. Here in Metro Manila, expect fair weather conditions aside from isolated rain showers or thunderstorm, mostly in the afternoon or evening. Next update for Tropical Depression Aghon will be at 11 o'clock in the morning. That's our weather update from Pag-asa. I am Aldzar D. Aurelio.
Thank you very much for that update, Aldzar.